Okay, let's get started. So first of all, a big welcome to all of you to coming to this special event here. I think I'm really happy that so many people are here, like people I know for many years, but also completely new faces. That's really nice. So really, thanks a lot for coming.
We're happy to be at this special place here. We are hosted today by Wikimedia, which is the organization behind Wikipedia, which is an organization, as you know, which tries to push forward free knowledge, free information, freedom of speech on the internet, which is super important. And of course, this also overlaps with our mission at Nextcloud, and this is why I'm really happy to be here today at this special place. And so thanks a lot for our hosts. So there are many reasons why this is a special event here. This is the first time we do it like that. Usually we give like presentation, product announcements during our conference or other events, but this is the first time we do our own event here. And there are several reasons for that. One of the reasons is it's actually a special day today. So it's actually a 10-year anniversary of this journey here, of this project. So actually, exactly today, 10 years ago, I was also standing on a stage. At the time, it looked like that. So this was actually, as I said, exactly today, 10 years ago. This was in San Diego in California. It was a keynote at a KDE conference where I announced this project. It was still under a different name, of course, as you might know, but it's still the same mission and still the same idea behind it and most of the same people and so on. Well, at the time, it was the benefit that the weather was a lot better than Berlin here. But beside that, similar stage and similar mission, but 10 years later now. That's really nice. Of course, the community grew a little bit since then. Right? This is the photo from our last conference here, also in Berlin. We have over 2,000 contributors to Nextcloud from all over the world, so it's actually a very big international open source project, one of the biggest, which I think is really, really cool that so many people from all over the place with different backgrounds come together and work together on this software and have the same mission behind it. And the mission is, of course, that we try to solve some of the negative trends that are on the internet at the moment. So we have a lot of centralization of cloud services, software as a service, where all the data is more and more locked in into data silos of a few big vendors. I mean, you all know all the big, huge cloud companies, and they suck up all the data from all the people, and they host all the main applications on the internet, and this is not healthy. So what we're trying to do here is to decentralize the infrastructure again, decentralize the internet. So that's our mission. There is a new term for that, digital sovereignty. That's a very relatively hot term at the moment. You hear this more and more, especially in politics, which means that everybody can be an individual, can also be a government or a company or some other organization, should be in control of their digital assets and their data and their applications and so on. So this is a big trend at the moment, and this is also something we want to achieve and provide with Nextcloud. We're doing this with a different business model than these big cloud companies. So we don't sell any software licenses. We are completely community-driven. We don't misuse user data. We don't spy on the data of the users. We don't sell advertising. And we don't do many of these other things that the big cloud companies do. So we are a bit of a counter model here for these big organizations. So as I mentioned, we're doing this for many years already, for close to 10 years. The best version, the latest version at the moment is Nextcloud 17. This is something we launched just 4 months ago at a conference in Berlin. I think it's a very good release. It has many improvements with the text editor or the remote wipe and many other things. and I think something really, really good. I hope that everybody is using it. So do you like it? What do you think? Is it good? Yeah, I think it's a really nice milestone. It's actually also used by a lot of big organizations. It's used by the German government, by the French government, by the European Commission, by actually many other people. So it's a big step forward. But I don't want to talk too much about the past here. I want to talk about the future and what's coming. I want to talk about what's coming in the next decade. So something that we're doing in the next 10 years. So for that, we actually want to look at the next major version of Nextcloud that we are launching today. And here we're doing some significant changes. So let's look a little bit back how this all started. So when I launched this 10 years ago, I focused on files. So it was all about file syncing and sharing. I called it at the time open source Dropbox. It's of course a bit stupid to identify yourself with a proprietary competitor, but at the end this is what it was. So you had like your files and your folders on your server, and you can synchronize it to all your devices and access it from everywhere. Relatively quickly it became clear that there's a need for more. And because of that we introduced this app concept where we had these plugins for all kinds of extensions running on top of this file sync and share solution. So for example, there was a photo gallery relatively quickly, there was an activity app, there was a chat, video calling app, email, contacts, and calendar. So relatively quickly, this became more than just files as a collection of all kinds of applications. But the thing was always that files were in the middle and the others were second-class citizens that could be installed or not. So it was all about file sync and share was still the core. And this is one of the changes that we do today, that we turn this around and we make everything a first-class citizen. Which means if you install this new version of Nextcloud, you get everything by default. So it's no longer just files and everything else you need to manually install, but everything is basically installed by default. And it's actually a bit funny because if you look at the list of these icons and you log in into this new Nextcloud version for the first time, then you see that they're exactly the icons here on top. Right? It's exactly the idea. So the navigation of these different apps is exactly what you get for the first time. Of course, this is not everything we did. We also improved the different pieces significantly. So I would like to go through each of them one by one and see what changes we made. So let's get started with the files part, the first part. There you have the basic interface that you already know, right? You can upload and download files. You can filter them. You can search them. There are recommended files on top. There are favorites and so on. You can also switch to a grid view, which works very nice, for example, with pictures. And you can extend this sidebar here, where you have like activities and chat and comments and sharing, of course, and versions and other things. Sharing is a very important part where we have especially advanced sharing features nowadays with a lot of options like read-only sharing or uploading only or sharing something without download options or password protected, sending a note to a recipient and many more options. So this becomes really, really useful. So this is all stuff that's more or less existed before, but we have built on top of that. The first thing is that we have a new sharing workflow. So it's now possible that you can send a share to someone that the other person has to accept. So you get a nice notification here where you can accept the share, and if you don't like it, then you don't get it. That's new. That's a new thing. The next thing is that it's very easily possible to transfer files and folders to other users. So if you have some files, if you're responsible for some project, and you want to transfer, for example, a complete structure to another user, then that's very easy here. Another new feature is something we call rich workspaces. So this is a nice way where you can document on top of a file list what these files are all about. So if I, for example, can say, here are my my photos, and this is the license, and this is where they come from, and we actually have embedded our Markdown editor here on top, where it can document what you what these files are and what you can do with it. So this is easy for photos here, but also for projects. Let's say you work together on a project, and there you can document, look here, this is out of all the files for a project, and these are the responsible people, and you can even have like a checklist here on top, and you can also document some of the workflows I will show you later, where I then can say that, look, every time a file is uploaded into the folder, there's automatic notification sent to a responsible person, or they're automatically converted to a PDF. Of course, they're also available on mobile, so there's also integration into the mobile app, so the mobile app also can show this information on top of the files list. And if you just access your files via WebDAV or via the desktop client, then all the information is just accessible in a README file, so you still have the information. The next feature is one of the longest feature requests we have, and this is file locking. So you can now lock a file and say, look, I'm working on this now. I don't want anyone else working on it at the same time, because if they do, you might get a merge conflict or something. You can lock it, and then you work on it. And if you're done, then you unlock it. Of course, if you want to work on a file which is locked by someone else, then you can still click on the name and start a chat and say, hey, what are you doing at the moment with this file? I also want to do it. You can synchronize and then work together. So this is a rough overview over the features, but I think everything becomes a bit clearer if you see it live. And because of that, I want to ask Jan, our design lead, to demo it to you.
Yeah, demo time. Let's see if this works. First, I need a screen mirroring setup, or I will just do it without it, I guess. So yeah, first thing, as Frank already mentioned, there's a lot of things, a lot of new improvements that we have, and that allow you to focus on your work. But one of the things that we also changed is a slight design update. So out with the dots, in with the gradient, and also the app icons. So now that we really treat everything as first-class citizens, we also directly show it. So let's see what this is. I'll just allow it, I guess. Couldn't read it. Anyway, so I will just log in here. So you see directly everything that is important for me is directly visible. Yeah, I see my workspaces, I see my recommended files, I see the favorites directly up top. If I'm in a subfolder, I also see the favorited folders directly here. Yeah, and yeah, I can just manage everything from here. It's like the home screen, basically. And so here I work, for example, on a specific project with Nina. I can see here also we use a project plan, for example. We use the task list in the rich workspaces to manage it. And then also in the sharing, we can see, for example, Roland is also part of this project. But then we always had this issue that you don't really see who else is part of the who else can access it via, for example, parent folders of the folder that Nina shared. And now we have this as this others with access entry. And now we see a whole bunch of other people actually have access through this parent folder that Nina shared with me. So I know exactly now who can access it, who can see the files, and who I can also probably talk to about it. And then additionally, you see here the project feature. We already connected it to a talk room, so it's directly all connected, and it just makes sense that it's all in one group. And yeah, as you might also see, that everything is kind of more readable, maybe. Maybe you don't see it now in the presentation, but you will feel it when you use it, because we increased the font size. So the base font size is all increased across the whole board. And yeah, so that helps a lot with readability and legibility. And the same we actually did across the board with the sidebar. So this whole sidebar, this sharing sidebar, the whole sharing design is standardized across all the apps. So for example, Calendar and Talk, they all use the same standardized sidebar. And this is, of course, a standard that you can use as an app developer as well. And so here, as I mentioned, if you want to focus again on the project itself, you have this the project planning here, and for example, you could change something like, I don't know, when you are finished with this presentation, you can just check it off, and you can also write a new thing. Yeah, actually, interestingly, this is also collaboratively. So you see, Roland just a few seconds ago edited it, because this just runs on our text app that we released with the last version, and so yeah. It just works, it's collaboratively, just like the folder. But there's one thing, of course, you also heard from Frank. If you don't like collaboration, or if there's specific files that are not really working collaboratively, for example, here we have a Photoshop file, you can lock them. So this one, for example, was locked by Nina. And in this case, yeah, I could unlock the file, and or I could chat with her and see how to unlock the file. Or here, for example, I can also lock the file, and then it's locked, and everyone else will see it's locked by me, and then I can say, unlock the file, and it's unlocked again. And yeah, and then the last thing, when you want to hand over a project, hand over a file, just like I will hand over the presentation back to Frank, basically, you go to the settings, and in the personal settings, in the sharing settings, you can transfer whole folders to another user. Yeah. That's basically it. Thank you.
Thanks a lot. So this is really, really cool, because a lot of features that we did over the years are actually coming together. It becomes this very nice collaborative workspace. And this really nice environment where you can really effectively work together in teams. And I'm really happy that we have this now. One of the challenges we had to show to people the power that is behind all these features, and because of that, we actually created some videos to show this to people. And the first one about Nextcloud Files, I want to show it to you now.
Nextcloud Files. With Nextcloud Files, you can manage all your files and documents. You can upload.
This was fast.
Nextcloud Files. With Nextcloud Files, you can manage all your files and documents. You can upload, download, edit, view, delete, and share them. Anything is possible. It is easy to find your files. You can use the distinctive feature to mark important files. By tagging, you can find files based on the topic. With a full text search, you can find files based on their content. Nothing gets lost anymore. In the sidebar, you can view the version of a file, leave comments, and see what happened to it. Share files and folders with others, and even chat about some documents. Nextcloud can show you file recommendations based on your past behavior. You can also look at your files in a grid view. It can show you the context of a folder with an innovative workspaces feature. You can easily document what the files on a folder are. You can also access and manage your files from mobile phones, tablets, and desktops. This is how it has to be.
What do you think? Very cool. But this is just the first app I want to mention today. There's a lot more. Let's go to the next one. The next one is the Photos app. So this is something some of the long-term Nextcloud users might think, what photos? That was the gallery. Yeah, we had the gallery app for a long time, and this was getting a little bit old, so we decided to completely build a new one, and this is Nextcloud Photos, which is the successor of Gallery. This is a completely new one where you can use to view your photos and manage it. It's very fast and responsive, and it's endless scrolling here, for example. It's very nice. You can filter your photos
by favorites and albums and tagging and other things. Of course, you can also watch your photos if you want, and you can also extend like a sidebar where you can easily share your photos with other people, with your friends and family, and you can even chat around a photo that is shared with others. So if you actually want to share your vacation pictures with your family, there's no need to upload it to Google or Facebook or some other centralized service. Right? You can share your data directly from inside Nextcloud. And if you have the new Maps app installed, you can even look where the photos are taken based on a map. So that's a very nice feature where you can see the different photos and where they are done. Well, that's very powerful. So the next app I want to cover now is Talk. This is, of course, a very important strategic feature from us. This is about chat and video calling. There are a lot of other chat and video calling apps on the internet, of course, but most of them are centralized services, which means they're all run by one service provider. You can't host it themselves. Nextcloud Talk is something you can host yourself. Some of the others claim to be, no problem, your data is end-to-end encrypted. Might be true, hard to say if they're proprietary, might be true. But something that's definitely clear is that the user accounts, they're all owned by this company. And all this company also knows all the metadata. Who talks with whom, how long, and so on. This is not the case. All the metadata is everything is on your server. So this is the most secure solution. So if you install, if you go into it for the first time, it might look like that. You have your different rooms and conversations on the side. You have your chats here. And you have some other related information on the right-hand side. You can filter conversations on top. That's a new feature. You can reply to messages, like here. That's another new feature. It's very useful. And one of the most popular feature requests, very important feature, the most important feature, we made the emojis bigger. Of course, a more serious improvement is the new flow to create new conversations. So you can create a new conversation with this new flow, and it also integrates with user-defined groups and circles. There's a feature for lobby, so you can create like a web meeting or a webinar where you can schedule a start time and all the other participants, they get like this wait screen. And if the time is reached, automatically the talk starts. There's a feature called video verification. That's a feature where you can do very secure sharing. So let's say you want to share a file with someone, you make it password protected, but you actually never transfer the password like over the internet, but you verify the identity of the other person with a video call and then give them the password. So this is a way to do super secure sharing. There's also integration for commands or chatbots. So there's an example here for our Pulse app, so directly in a chat channel, you can execute different commands or do polls and do all kinds of other things. Of course, this is all a web interface so far, but there's a lot more. There's, for example, the mobile apps. So here's an incoming calling screen. So if someone calls you, this just looks like a normal phone call, but it all goes through your Nextcloud Talk server. The reply feature is also on mobile, and multi-account is also now here in the iOS app. So you can actually connect to different servers, or in this case, you can have different identities, which some people might like, I don't know. Okay, but again, these are just screenshots. I think it's better if you believe me, if you see it live, and for that I want to ask Nina to show it to us in the demo.
Hi everyone. So I have an extra challenge, which is to move the mouse on the trackpad on this huge screen. So no judgment, please. So you've been introduced to files before, but I think we all know that sometimes sharing a file is not enough to collaborate and that you actually need context and discussion about this. So basically what you want is to be able to start a conversation around the file that you share. So this is doable in Nextcloud, and I've actually had the use case recently. Okay. Because like that. Okay, so I had the use case recently with Roland because we were working on this transcript file, and now I need to gather some feedback from him. It's already shared, so we can start the conversation. So I joined the conversation with Roland, and well, hi Roland, like I need some feedback. He might take some time to actually give me some feedback. So in the meantime, I will go over my other team conversations. So now you are in Talk. Talk is very straightforward. Basically, you get this overview of everything that happens, all your conversations, all the people you talk to. It's all in the left sidebar. But the most part of your screen is actually dedicated to what is most important, which is your current conversation. And so if we have a look at this company chat that I have, yes, I want to show notifications, absolutely. Does it work better? I hope. Well, so as Frank said, we introduced something very useful, which is the reply feature, because it lets you reply directly to message, which gives you more context in terms of smoothness of the conversation flow. So sometimes you don't have to make it very difficult, very complex, but at least it works. And I see that Roland already has gathered the feedback. So what does he want? Yeah, he wants me to send a picture that we plan to use to illustrate this. It's very easy to share directly from your files inside of Talk. So, of course, you can have my feedback and illustration. And now he wants to call me, which I actually would like to do because it's not easy to type with the microphone. So, yeah, sure, let's have a call. Hi, Roland. Wow, looks like you are with quite a busy audience. Okay, can you hear me properly? I guess so. We are in the same room, so that helps. okay, so I think I can also share my camera. And enable video. Yeah, sure. Hey. Yeah, thank you for the screen sharing. We had this discussion that we didn't know if we wanted to illustrate with landscape or with animals. Actually, I like your option better. Is it the Netherlands? It looks nice. I like it. Okay. And also, like, so I can tell you, since we are in a conversation, so I had asked you for some feedback about this presentation that you never gave. And I'll be honest, it's a bit late now. So, well, can you at least let me know if everything went well? Thank you.
Okay, very cool. Okay, so I think this is a very, very impressive tool where you can communicate and collaborate around the document and really work together in a team very efficiently. And again, to show it to you, we again created a video and I want to play it to you now.
Nextcloud Talk. With Nextcloud Talk, you can chat, do video calls, and collaborate around your documents. Communication is the key. Just saying. Hey, Carl. Nice hair, by the way. You have chat rooms about topics, one-on-one chats where you can even invite external participants. And on top of that, you can group files and rooms and other resources into projects. You can easily integrate external applications and scripts into your chat workflows. Calls can be scheduled for a specific time. This is, for example, useful for web meetings or webinars. you will never miss a call again, except when you want to miss them. With Nextcloud Talk, you can do video calls and screen sharing with several people at once. You can also chat and do video calling with the native mobile apps. You will get push notifications every time you get a call or a new chat message, like this one here.
Okay. Let's move to the next app, which is the calendar. Calendar is something that existed for quite some time in Nextcloud, but we actually decided to completely rewrite it. So at the moment, in Nextcloud, the next version, we have the calendar 2.0, which is a significant improvement. So first of all, it has a completely refreshed new user interface here. So it's faster and cleaner and easier to use, but it's also a complete enterprise-grade calendar, which means you can access all the entries from your phone and tablet and desktop, and there's even an Outlook connector. So this becomes a real completely enterprise-grade groupware tool here. It has all the usual functionalities, like sending invitations to people, sharing calendars, reminders, recurring events, and so on, free busy booking, and everything you expect. But of course, we didn't want to stop there, so we also created some of the more interesting features. So this is, for example, there's a nice way to, if you create an event and you invite some people, then with one click you can create a talk room directly and attach the link to the room to all to this meeting and send invitations to everybody. So it's basically schedule a web meeting is just one additional click. So that's very useful. The next feature, the next app I want to mention is Mail. We have a very nice mail interface. It has all the usual functionalities that you expect from a nice mail client. It also has auto-provisioning, which means if you run this in your organization, then if everybody would just install, logs into Nextcloud, automatically has their mail pre-configured here. It supports multi-accounts, so you can connect different mail accounts, and even has GBG encryption support. Of course, it integrates into Nextcloud files with attachments, so you can attach files to your mail, and there's also an app where all attachments that you get by mail is then saved in files back. So it's a very nice file integration in both directions. So this is just an, I would say, a state-of-the-art, powerful mail client, but again, we wanted to do something special, something unique that doesn't exist anywhere else. And because of that, we're really happy that we teamed up with our friends from the KDE community to integrate a special feature where we can actually detect tickets in mails. So if you get a booking confirmation from your train company or from your hotel or from your airline, then it's automatically detected. And with just one click, you can add it to your calendar. And that's not just something that works for like two or three ticket types, but actually the KDE community, Volker is here in the room, did an amazing job. So this is compatible with hundreds of ticket types from different like bus companies and train companies and airlines and hotel chains and so on. So this is very, very nice. And again, you know what's coming now. Of course, we create another video to show it to you.
Groupware. In the Nextcloud calendar, you can manage and share all your appointments. Everything works better now with my line dance group. Yeehaw! You can easily create new calendar entries, then even create a Nextcloud talk room associated with the entry. Hey Carl, are you in next week? I got something for you to keep your schedule up to date. Check this. All the calendars can be synced and accessed on your mobile phone or desktop, including Outlook. No more excuses. In Nextcloud Contacts, you can view, manage, and share all your contacts. You can also group them together based on topics. In Nextcloud Mail, you can read and write all your emails. The attachment handling is integrated into Nextcloud files. Nextcloud Mail detects itineraries, showing you information about your trip that you can easily add to your calendar. Perfectly organized. Now you can get started. Texas, here I come. The land of line dancing. Yeehaw!
Okay, so the next app I want to cover is Nextcloud Flow. So this is an innovative workflow engine that's part of this Nextcloud release. Some of you might remember that we did a pre-announcement for that at a conference. This is why we wanted to ask other people to give feedback and integrate it into their software, which some of already did. That's very amazing. But this is a very nice workflow engine. So it helps you to automate processes and boring tasks and everything else, and can be automated, of course. So there's a way to get like a notification if a specific file is changed or uploaded, or with a special text, or something is happening with some Excel file over a specific size. Or you can say, I want to post about this file change into a specific chat channel. You can say every time the sales team stores a new order in a specific folder, there's notification in the sales chat channel, for example, that's very useful. Or external scripts can be executed, which is something we worked did together with some universities, because you can trigger like external systems, supercomputers, do some analysis based on uploading of specific raw data. There's something that can be done. We can automatically tag files based on specific requirements, and also do automatic PDF conversion if something is in a specific folder. I showed you earlier this screenshot about a workplace. This is a great place where this all comes together. So we can say here, this is project folder, and every time someone updates a folder here, there's a message in the specific chat room. So you know what your colleagues are doing, and oh, okay, someone worked on this requirements document, and everybody can see it. Or you can also say, like, I don't know, Word files are automatically converted to PDFs if you want to. So as I mentioned, we did a preview for that like 4 months ago and asked other people to integrate, and some community people even did. For example, there is Rello, which is also here in the audience, who is working on this amazing data analysis app, which is released soon, I think. And he already integrated Flow into this app. So this app can do nice visualization of raw data that's available in Nextcloud. And this can be triggered every time the file is changed. So every time the file is changed, there's a new graph automatically generated. So this is a nice example of a workflow. Yeah, exactly. Thanks. Next topic is desktop and mobile, because I talked a lot about the server, but of course Nextcloud is also all about mobile and desktop. So we also have significant improvement in this area. For example, on the mobile clients, we have integration of this new edit action. So every time there's a file, a Word file or a text file or something, you can go and edit, and then an editor that's available on the server is automatically launched, and you can automatically edit it directly in the app natively. And that's also a way to generate like native files from your phone. The desktop client has a new beta release out today, which is very cool because it has a complete new interface. Some of you might know the current desktop client, which is very technical. So you see a lot of technical information like sync logs and other things. But a lot of people think that actually the content shouldn't be more in the foreground. Like someone mentions you, a file is changed, or something else is happening. So this is all like seen a lot nicer now. And this will come out very soon. And as I said, this is a screenshot of the beta, which is available today. Okay, so now I'm done with all those different apps and all these improvements. And you might think already, wow, this is a lot of things and a lot of areas. And we bundle all those apps by default and so many improvements all over the place. And we thought the same. There's a lot happening. And this is why we decided to call the next Nextcloud version not 18, as you might think, to actually give it a special name, a new name, because we think we reached a complete new product category here. So today I'm really happy to say that we have a new name, and the name is Nextcloud Hub. So Nextcloud Hub is like your hub for your digital life, for all your data and for all your communication. This is the place where everything comes together. So this is our new name. Okay, so we really think that this is a significant step forward, where you have like your files and your chat and your calendar and your contacts and everything together, everything self-hosted, everything open source, of course. And this is really something where open source can compete with the big American cloud companies. Of course, yeah. But then you might think, wait, is not Frank a bit exaggerating here? Isn't there something missing? Isn't there something like something else that's missing in a real work context? What?
Docs.
Docs. Yeah, exactly. Yeah, that is what people do sometimes, right? Working on documents, yeah? From time to time. Yeah. What about Office? I mean, isn't there like a way to edit like Office documents? That's a very important feature, of course. And as you know, there are already some Office options available in Nextcloud. So we have a partnership with our friends from OnlyOffice, for example, who provide that. We have a partnership with Collabora. You can even integrate Microsoft Office Online into Nextcloud if you really want to. So there are several different options that you can do, but they are all a bit difficult because we did some surveys in our user base, and roughly only 10% of the Nextcloud users have something like that installed. The reason is that you need to run a special Docker container, you need like a reverse proxy, you need some configuration. It's actually a little bit difficult. But we were thinking, what can we do to bring something like that to 100% of our users? What can we do to make this so super easy that all this crazy configuration is not really needed? So this is something that was discussed and worked for a long, 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 long time, literally years. And for roughly a year, we're actually working on a solution. So we actually teamed up with our partners from OnlyOffice to build a solution for this problem. So I'm really happy to say that every Nextcloud Hub installation actually contains, out of the box, a fully working Office suite. So it looks like that. It's just the OnlyOffice interface, as some of you might know. In the front end, looks very, very similar. It's installed by default. It has nice integrated front end. For example, you have the sidebar with all the sharing and commenting and chatting, as we mentioned before. With the difference that is installed by default, it's a full working Office suite with text, spreadsheet, presentations, everything you expect, with collaborative editing, everything you expect. It runs fully on-premise, it's open source, and there's no configuration needed. Of course, there are some technical limitations. So this is nothing that can replace like the full-fledged products of our partners. But it's not a problem because it's very easy to upgrade this built-in solution into something like the real OnlyOffice Enterprise, which is a lot faster and has more features, or Collabora Online or Microsoft Office Online. So this is absolutely possible. As you might know what's coming now, I also want to show you a video. So I hope.
Document collaboration. With Nextcloud, you can edit all your Office documents. You can do this in the browser, on your mobile, or on the desktop. Just click on a document. Now you can edit it. That's it. It's simple. And the best part of it, you don't even need a full Office suite installed. What was the text again before I changed it yesterday? Oh, I'll just have a quick look. That's no problem, because you can restore older versions, leave comments on the document, and see what happened to it. If you want to edit your document together with somebody else, just share it. Look, it's that easy. Carl, Paulette, and Mickey, bam, welcome to the party. You can invite people on the same server or people who are on a remote federated server, or just invite people by email or share directly on a chat channel. And you're done. Now let's work together. With the different cursors in the document, you can see what others are doing in real time. So we work together much faster and more efficiently. You can chat with people while they are working on your document. Can you edit the choreography till tomorrow? If chatting is not enough, you will love this function. You can do a video call with the people who are collaborating with you on the document. Of course, only if your hair looks nice, or just use a cover up for your face. Just kidding. You can do all of this on mobile too, while you're on the road or at a meeting. Or in the restroom, but nobody does that, right? And once everyone is done, all the changes are automatically synced back to your desktop and all your other devices. This is how it has to be done.
So this is really the result of a lot of work, as you can imagine. There's a lot of work being done with a new backend and all kinds of integration things. But most important, this was, of course, only possible because we work together with our partner, OnlyOffice. I'm happy that Galina from OnlyOffice is here. Maybe you can come to the stage for a second. So, thanks a lot. And want to say something?
Yes. Hi, everyone. So I just wanted to say a huge thank you for working together to Nextcloud team. We are really working together for quite a long time, and today it's a very important step to really shorten the way from downloading OnlyOffice for Nextcloud and usage start. So now it's really easy to start to use it. It's available for all the Nextcloud instances by default. It's easy to use. It's easy to upgrade to Enterprise Edition if you really need it. And now we really can concentrate on next level of security and new features. So really, thank you.
Thanks a lot. Okay, so I think this is a really really nice milestone that we have here together, where all the pieces come together to be the first real alternative to this big American cloud services. Of course, if you look at all these components that are part of Nextcloud Hub, you might get the impression that this is all that's there, and that's not true, because of course we still have this huge ecosystem of third-party apps. So there are over 200 apps for all kinds of use cases, for like vector drawing or some social things or some other alternatives. So on our huge community, and more are added every day. And this is something that I think makes Nextcloud as an ecosystem even more powerful. Okay, now it's the question, of course, what about availability? So when can I get all of that? And now there are some companies who are very good with pre-announcements. I don't like that too much. So everything I showed you today is actually available today. So you can go now to our website, to our download server, download it, use it today. You can also go to our demo server and test it if you want. So and this is all production ready, available today. So we gave some journalists some pre-access to the software and asked for feedback. And some gave us feedback, very nice one. I want to share two specifically. There's first Jack Wallen from Tech Republic, who said, never before I've been impressed by with a piece of open source software. So that's a very nice quote. And there's, of course, the Spiegel, who says Nextcloud is a counter model to the typical cloud offerings of the large US providers such as Microsoft, which is also true. Okay, so I'm at the summary here. So I think what we have here doesn't exist anywhere else. So this combination of completely self-hosted rich features, federated, open source, and everything else community-driven doesn't exist anywhere else. We have all the modern collaboration and communication features that are expected nowadays. Everything we do is open source and on-premise, 100%. Right? There is no like hidden proprietary features anywhere. This is a commitment from us. Everything is 100% open source. There is no vendor login. Right? You can use it and do whatever you want with it. There is no contract that force you to not use the software as you want. Doesn't exist. Everything is federated and distributed. Everything is secure and privacy aware. That's the whole mission behind it. And everything is community driven. So Nextcloud is, as you know, of course, a company, but we are only a small part of the community. The community is a lot bigger, and only together with the bigger community we can achieve that. So I started this presentation when I said, like, look, 10 years ago I started this idea. I think now 10 years later, I think we can change the game again for the next 10 years. And I would say, Microsoft, Google, Box, Dropbox, brace yourself. The open source community is coming after you. So, thanks a lot. Okay. Because this is only the first part of our announcements. There's actually a little something more, which I think is equally interesting, or maybe even more interesting. So I think I convinced you that Nextcloud Hub is a very powerful software that has a lot of benefits in productivity and security and other areas, and of course something that you should use. But of course, then the question is, how can I use it? There's always the question, how do I get it? I mean, there are some people who can just download it from our website and host it themselves, or, I don't know, run it on a Raspberry Pi or somewhere else. But for a lot of users, it's actually very important to get Nextcloud hosted by a service provider. So this is something that makes it convenient for big companies and also private users. And for a long time, of course, we are working together with service providers, but today we have a special announcement, because actually today we announce a collaboration with the biggest European service provider, and this is IONOS by 1&1. And I'm really happy to have Rainer here, SVP Global Platform Hosting, to tell us a little bit more about our partnership here.
Thank you, Frank. Yeah, thanks, Frank. First of all, it's a pleasure being here and being part of this amazing journey. And it's I didn't know that it's 10 years old, so I'm really looking forward for the next 10 years. And I'm happy to be part of the journey and contribute to this journey. Now, let me find the right button. So here we are. So there, Frank already mentioned a couple of reasons why to use Nextcloud, and that was already amazing and convincing. But I just want to emphasize on two reasons that really drives us moving forward as a German cloud provider. And everything, the whole journey of IONOS started actually in Germany, in Karlsruhe. There are two things, and these two things are really kind of pushed forward and upward in the press as well. The first one is data sovereignty. And the question is, how do we get this? And in our daily life, and that affects myself as well, we feel so much kind of linked into the US companies and even into the Chinese companies. So how can we kind of build our own data sovereignty? And one solution is rely on open source and open standards. And that's what we're really pushing forward in our company as well as together with all the partners. So one way to really get independent, get sovereign, is using open source. And open source is super, super powerful. Once you get really in touch with the open source ecosystem, there was even Eric Rabreska from GitHub just doing a cool presentation a couple of months ago saying, hey, we have 40 million developers, 40 million developers contributing each year on the GitHub repository. And the biggest 10,000 projects have 75,000 contributors. This is more than the Fortune 500 companies in the world have. So the power of open source is unbelievable. And that's why we're so enthusiastic about but products like Nextcloud, which have the combination of open source, globally contribution. Everybody can decide what to do with open source. Everybody can contribute. If you want to change something, just change it, do it. So we're really kind of thrilled by this open source approach, and just make sure that open source runs on our platform. So what we provide is platforms. I'm responsible for the hosting and cloud platform in IONOS since about 7-8 years now. And it's an amazing journey that we have they've done so far. And together with Nextcloud, I think we have a kind of really cool future in front of us. And you probably know that here, especially in Germany and in Europe, we try to get more and more sovereignty over time. So data sovereignty is one of the key drivers that pushed us forward, having Nextcloud running on our German data centers for our customers to give them really kind of additional benefit, And the second one is legal certainty. We have a lot of customers, especially the small, mid-sized customers, who are really kind of afraid of putting software somewhere else than a local data center. And I'm not saying that these local data centers of most small companies are really safe. They're not. They don't have the power, the people, the knowledge, really, to drive data centers up to a security level that is required nowadays. So it's really this uncertainty which we have to overcome. We have to help these companies to gain this certainty. Now, first of all, which makes them more comfortable is German legislation. I think most companies, and even myself, would be really struggle with legislation of companies in China and even in the US. It's tough and probably sometimes even a no-go. And GDPR. In Germany, you call it DSGVO. So this is really how to protect your data. It's your data. You're owning this data. Nobody else owns this data. Nobody has the right, really, to get this data, steal this data, or use this data for whatever without your allowance. And Cloud Act actually is doing this. Cloud is effectively saying, hey, if these guys want, they will take your data. And we're not okay with it. That's very simple. We're not okay. So to gain this data sovereignty, I think we have to build this platform, hosting cloud platform that we can support here out of Germany, the German company, the European company, together with Nextcloud, allowing us really to have this independent and sovereign system. Now, how are we going to do this? It's a start of a journey, and it always starts with kind of getting known each other. That took some time now, and we were absolutely amazed about learning about Frank's and Frank's visions. But the first step is that we start this collaboration for today. We guarantee and we make sure that the software is seamlessly running on our platforms that we have. But there's more to come. This is starting of a journey. We want to have much deeper technology integration without getting vendor login. So I'm really a big fan of what Frank said. Vendor login is a no-go. You, as a customer, have to have the right to move the data wherever you want at whatever time. I'm proud to have a cool platform in place. I'm sure customers will love the platform together with this product, but when they want to move, they can move. Very simple. So no vendor login, even though we try to integrate the platform to make it for our users as simple as possible to use this product and have an easy entry into the system. At the same time, we want to contribute because there are a couple of things we learned in our experience being a cloud provider. We have a few million customers that really give us regular feedback, and we would love really to forward this feedback to Nextcloud as well and make sure that this product gets better by contributing as everybody can do. So, Frank, thanks a lot. It's a pleasure having the starting point here. I'm looking forward really for a big, big journey and for the next 10 years.
Thank you.
Yeah, thanks a lot. The only thing for me left is now also to say thank you for all of you coming and watching the live stream and being interested in what we are doing. We still have some drinks and snacks here prepared. I hope you still stick around a little bit for some chatting and conversations and interesting exchange. And I hope this was interesting for you. Thanks for coming and have fun with Nextcloud Hub. Thank you.